In Construct 2, the no-save behavior can be used when using save games to exclude certain object states from being saved. Normally, every object, its properties, and parameters will be saved and restored. With no-save, you can exclude an object from the save file, causing it to always resort to its original state. Let's take a look at how to use the no-save behavior and some of the reasons why you should be using it. To use the no-save behavior, we need to have a level to save, with objects in it that can be affected. Because of that, I have this layout set up, and we won't be covering any of the setup. We're only going to discuss the no-save behavior. But before we talk about the no-save behavior, let me explain what the game does. First, we start out on the start screen layout. From there, we can start the game or load the game. For now, let's just start the game. From here, we can quit and go back to the start screen. Let's start again. If we click the gem to start with, nothing happens. First, we have to kill the enemies. We can click on the green guys and they get smaller. After a few clicks, they disappear. The demon is the same way. Click it and it gets smaller until it's destroyed. Now that all of the enemies are destroyed, we can click on the gem and collect it. Let's quit the game and restart it. When we click the start button, the layout is run from its default state, like it's the first time you played it. Right now, none of the objects have the no-save behavior applied. I'll click the first guy a few times, and the demon a couple times. Now, let's see what happens when we save the game. I'll click save, and then quit the game. Now, if I click start, notice the size of the enemies, full size. If I quit, but this time click the load button, the level is loaded, restoring the state of each enemy. If I go ahead and complete the level, kill all of the enemies, and collect the gem, I can save the game, quit, and load the game, and the level is still complete. Let's say hypothetically that this level is one of many. When you find this level, you have to kill the enemies, the demon, and collect the gem. But if you leave the level, or exit out of the game, and come back later, we want the enemies to remain dead, but the demon to come back to life. The gem will remain collected, so there's no longer any reward, but if you enter the level, the boss is still there. We can do this with the no-save behavior. Just select the demon object, and click on Behaviors. Click Add New, and select No Save under the Attributes category. That's it. Now the demon object will be excluded from any save files, and the demon state will always be restored after a save is loaded. When you save a game, all objects and their properties are saved to a file. The more objects and properties you have, the larger that file size will be. So a great use of the No Save behavior is on background images or other static pieces of the HUD. The background will never change depending on gameplay, so there's no reason to save its properties, position, etc., when it will always be restored to its default value. By adding the no-save behavior to the background, you'll save the space in the file size. It might not seem like a background image's size would make any difference in a save file since they're not very large, but remember that they have to load into memory when the layout is launched. By keeping your save files small in size, you'll get better loading speeds and get your players into the game faster. Remember, use the no-save behavior when you're using save and load functionality on any object that is static or unchanging, or on text objects that update regularly every tick. Anything you can exclude from the save file, do so by using the no-save behavior.